7. And today, we will finally be challenging the champion. But before we go ahead and do that, we have to heal up our team. Again, I apologize for how ungraceful my last two battles were in the last episode. Pokemon team. I class legendaries for sure. Yes, dragon type, so I'm switching to 18 real quick. Just in case I remember correctly. But we're gonna go ahead and check his place real quick. Dang it, he has the really cool background. I like this one too. I don't know what I like, the stars and gradients. I don't know if you guys watched my painting vlog, but this is very much the vibe of my painting. So maybe that's why I like it so much. I connect with it. Same with Kyla's gym. It was like the same wallpaper, just different colors. But let's stop stalling and just get into this battle with maybe Rugra.
Surprised to see me. I guess you would be. Why would I, Rugra, be the champion?
We are right, it's Rugra. I hope you were right about his team being dragon types.
I don't even battle. Usually, I just send Tayan to do my work.
Maybe it was Tayan's team we're remembering with all the dragon types. Uh-oh.
I've spent my life seeking perfection. Deltas, Megas, Armors, Mew, too. The entire fiasco with the Unova dragons. It's all futile. Nothing's worked so far.
So I'm guessing he did have a Sherman Sacrum at one point, because that's the Unova dragons, right?
Everything was strong, but just not strong enough.
Well, I'm sensing a pattern here. They all had one thing in common. You. Maybe you're the weak link, Mr. Rugra. Please don't kill me.
You know what the worst part was? How ridiculous people find our goals to be. No Pokemon is perfect. It's impossible. Anything can be beaten with a good type matchup, high stats, and appropriate moves. And you know what? Maybe they're right. Maybe we've taken the wrong approach to this. A perfect, unbeatable Pokemon. It's kind of a stupid thought. After all, a combination like Destiny Bond and Shadow Tag can take anything out easily.
I don't know what that means.
But a strategy that can take out a perfect Pokemon can't take out an entire team. I'm realizing this now. Having one powerful Pokemon doesn't make you perfect. It can still be beaten.
Oh shoot, I'm getting psyched out. I'm kind of scared now.
But a team of powerful Pokemon, perfectly synchronized. Each covering each other's weaknesses and increasing their strengths. A team like that could have no weaknesses. It could be undefeatable. It could be perfect. And now, with that team, I am perfect. So bring it on, Chicha. You want to be the champion of the Torin region? Be my guest, but you'll have to be the person who's beaten the Elite Four before you with their perfect team. Get ready to lose.
I'm really nervous. Ew, he's ugly.
He's not ugly, he just spooked me. But he looks like a Rick and Morty character. Like he belongs in that cartoon. But champion.
Oh my god, what is that? And there's Sandstorm.
am a little bit afraid because he does have earthquakes, so.
We're gonna hope that since he saw 18, he's gonna go with earthquake, but we're gonna juke him. And we were wrong. Dang it. The sandstorm range is at least just need to make sure he doesn't get any critical hits or anything. But whatchamacallit? I'm gonna have to revive one of my Pokemon at one point. But we could finish this with one flamethrower. think this could be the battle where we build up calm mind. Vulcan is so much faster though. But we can stall. Sledge Wave is the only one I'm uncertain with that will, like a KO 18. But the other two, I'm not worried about. And I have leftovers on 18. I kind of wish I put more leftovers on more of my Pokemon. It's Tyranitar in the first half, and then Volcarona in this half. Tyranitar we could probably take out with Flygon's Earthquake, and we've just found out we can use Volcarona to basically build up 18 all the way. So I'm just taking notes for when I do have to battle him again. Oh, but that was just a second. Okay, we got Flygon. This is bad because he has Earthquake for sure. We have to make sure Ice Beam hits and it doesn't miss. Dang it. Mega Flygon's so gross looking. I don't like Mega Flygon, honestly. He looks weird. Like, might get sweeped because of Mewtwo. Maybe we should have nuzzled. Yes, the life orb is what's freaking me out. So now we know he has Psy Shock and Dark Pulse, so I'm gonna go ahead and try Eruption in case Spice survives Psy Shock. But honestly, Psy Shock with Life Orb. Spice is very, very much a my tanky Pokemon. I have no idea how he's surviving any of this. But maybe he's just like better special defense than all the other. Now we can just get him to hurt himself over and over with Life Orb while we stall. I know, this is such a, like, this is such like a cheesy or sleazy way of winning, but... Ah yes, full restore. Punk. What a punk. Let's try Flamethrower. Did you guys see that weird glitch where it said Mewtwo to regain itself? Weird, right? I don't think the game expected someone who spams items to play against the champion. I don't know, maybe I'm not the only one who plays like this. I'm pretty sure I'm not. Let me know in the comments if you're an item spammer like me. Watch my Insurgence playthrough sound very competitive, or like play Pokemon competitively, or at least a little bit more than I do. So I'm actually curious, like, what everyone's play style is like, because I'm very much this passive. I'm a staller, which is why I like moves like paralysis or poison. She was the main reason. much don't have a good comp. I very much won against the previous gym trainers using my stalling strat. Okay. What is that? It looks like a delta. Wait a minute, it's a water type. It's a shark and it has metal chains on it. I'm scared the metal chains, well, I mean it's a dual type, like metal and water. Or I could just be psyching myself out and it could be just be a straight up dark water type Pokemon. Cause it does have like the elements of looking like a dark type with the creepy eyes and the design. Kinda like a crocodile or something like that. I'm gonna try with eruption real quick. Ooh, should I heal first? Oh no, I'm getting iffy. I'm gonna try with eruption. Dang it. So it's a water type for sure. Waterfowl is very strong. Also, I don't know if, what order Rukro will pull out his Pokemon next round, because sometimes they pull out different Pokemon, different orders, like Mewtwo might come earlier and sabotage my, 18. So, I'm gonna go ahead and full restore 17 real quick, but I don't know if he'll survive Waterfall. Oh yes, Earthquake. A double no-no on 17 because he's metal and trying to think now. Shoot. So yes, Earthquake and Waterfall, which are two things that would have killed Spice. See what I told you guys. isn't doing anything. Okay. Okay, but Iron Tail is very strong. Okay, that scared me. Yay. Oh, we did it. Oh my god, we did it. First try. Ugly. We tripped. We fell. We scrambled. We crawled. We tripped again. We got stepped on. We got a concussion. We woke up. Got lost. Regained our memory. And crawled again. And somehow ended up in the finish line. But we did it. I'm pretty sure. It took me a pretty, like, half an hour for this win, but I'm not sure. I'm gonna have to edit. I'm gonna do a lot of editing, so it might not even be an accurate time frame, but I'm a little bit flustered because I didn't expect to win, especially after losing half of my team first Pokemon, because I forgot Flygonkin in Earthquake. I think Earthquake is super effective against Tyranitar. Flygon didn't survive long enough for me to test it out, but it's okay. Reptar pulled through. We may not have used Reptar as much this whole time in the Pokemon League, but he pulled through in the champion. Big shout out to Spice and 18 though, because 18 with the almost sweep, and Spice for holding out for a lot of the moves Mewtwo and Volcarona were throwing at him. Just enough for me to pull through with the other Pokemon I have, but yeah. Enough rambling. Let's make sure we get through this dialogue.
Oh, for crying out loud. We got $93,000 for winning.
That's not $93,000. $9,300 for winning. I expected $93,000, considering you're the champion and you're a cult leader, but whatever.
So, that's it then. What a battle.
Maybe.
Maybe it seems like I have a little more to learn about all of this. After all, we'll meet again, I'm sure of it, and my team will be better and stronger.
What are you talking about? Why am I battling you again?
Rukra.
Who's Sylvan? Is this a new character or is that someone I'm forgetting?
Sylvan, it's been a while. Congratulations, Chicha. I can't believe it. Just recently, you were in my lab choosing your very first Pokemon.
Oh, she's the professor of this game. That's why I don't remember. That's all the way back in episode like one or two. Like 2 years ago. Circle. We've really taken this long.
And now you're the champion of the Torin League. That's amazing. I'm so proud of you. Come, let's get you registered in the Hall of Fame. Sylvan. For keeping my secret, for everything. Sure, Rukra, I do it for anyone. I just wish I could have helped you more. Come on, Chicha, let's go.
I'm very confused. So she knew our champion was a cult leader. I thought cult leaders were frowned upon.
Congratulations, Chicha. This is where I record you and your team to be remembered as champions forever. But before I do, I have a message I should pass on to you. A man who is partnered with Victini asked you to meet him where you met Mew. Victini. Can you believe that? What a cool Pokemon. But yeah, he wanted to see you. He wouldn't say who he was, only that you'd know. In Amphitrite City, he mentioned, you'd know specifically where. So, that's your next goal, I guess. I'm not really sure what's going on with all of that. But anyways, I digress. Congratulations, Chicha. You've done so much for this region, and now you've beaten its league. You deserve it. Welcome to the Hall of Fame. League champion, congratulations.
Oh my god, I forgot we're cosplaying as a demon lord. We look so ridiculous, but so is our team.
Nice, we made it to the credits. I'm gonna just let this play, kind of like when I finished the Pokemon League in
Sword and Shield. I'll just let the credits roll and we can just talk about what happened today. Maybe I don't want to talk about it actually. I'm kidding.
I'm not super ashamed of how I won the Pokemon League, mainly because that's always been my playstyle. And honestly, Pokemon Insurgence, especially the Pokemon League, was really hard for me, and I don't think I would have won any other unless I kept losing over and over and eventually, you know, figured out what Pokemon they were using, what moves at all times. Like, I guess if I tried to win it the normal way, per se, and I didn't bring as many potions or revives, this would definitely take a lot longer for me to do. But did it still feel cheesy or sleazy to win the way I did? A little bit, yeah. Especially because of how many potions I had to go through and that it's all recorded and on the internet for people to see. But am I ashamed or embarrassed? Again, yeah, just a little bit, but not enough for me not to do it again. It's just how I win. I'm definitely gotten better thanks to the tips and advice you guys have given me over the couple of years I've been playing this game, but the fact that I've been playing Pokemon like this for over, like, however long Pokemon's been around, 10 years, 15 years that I've been playing, I don't know, I can't do simple basic math right now. I just used all my brain power to outplay Rukra, but it's like that saying, it's hard to teach an old dog new tricks. Like, I've been doing or battling like this for so long that I would have to like dedicate myself and like practice competitive Pokemon battle styles, but I don't think that would be something I would enjoy or even have time to do. But now that we've basically made it through the main chunk of the game and as the credits showed, we basically finished the game. I just want to let you guys know how much I appreciate you guys, like, giving me all the advice you guys have over this playthrough, over the course of this playthrough. And you guys stuck through it. To watch me battle, but you guys gotta admit I did have my moments. But yeah, that was the Pokemon League, and we beat the champion. Just gonna end the episode here. I guess the question I have is, like, what were your guys' thoughts on Rugra being the champion? Maybe I should have expected it, considering the whole theme of Insurgence is cultists, so maybe I should have thought that maybe one of the cult leaders was the champion. I'm not sure. I don't know. I was still shocked.
Who did you guys think the champion was? A new character? Or maybe you guys thought it was an old character? Maybe you guys did guess it was Rugra? And just let me know.
I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Again, we did it. We made it through. Please take care and stay hydrated. For now, I hope you are sleepy.
Good.